Hey Gemini, welcome to your weekly reading for October 18th to the 24th. My name is Johanna. Welcome to Tenacious Soul. We're going to go through some general messages for you guys for the week, so take what resonates, leave the rest. You can always check out your sun, your moon, and your rising sign. Let's kind of see where we go for you guys. What does Gemini need to know this week? Gemini. All right, we have third chakra, number 37, which is the solar plexus chakra. Bottom of the deck, we have number 22, yin and yang. All right, so I feel like you're kind of stepping into your power. I feel like there's a sense of balance and harmony kind of like within your energy, Gemini, where it's like you're in control of a situation is kind of what I feel. Or just you're feeling more in control of a situation or just your life in general for some of you. Some of you could be completing something at this time as well, like with the 37 that breaks down to a 10, which is a completion of a cycle. We have 22, which is a master number. But yeah, so let's kind of see where the tarot takes us, Gemini. What does Gemini need to know this week? Okay, we have the Two of Pentacles. We have the World card. We have the Wheel of Fortune. The Knight of Swords. We have the Magician. The Queen of Cups. We have the Eight of Swords. The Page of Pentacles. And the Knight of Pentacles. Bottom of the deck, we have the Three of Pentacles. All right. So strong energy here with this magician here, which is your energy. It's like you're creating something. I see you wanting to take action towards something. There is like a sense of trying to build with the Three of Pentacles. Some of you could be collaborating with people or just like working together on something, or you're just busy with work in general with the Three of Pentacles. This could be have something to do with your work situation or just your practical world. But I do see you going from like the two to the three with the Two of Pentacles here starting out. So some of you really kind of like to with the Two of Pentacles, we have the World and we have the Wheel of Fortune here. So there's some sort of completion. Again, we have a cycle completing here, a change happening for you. The Two of Pentacles can be a card of change, needing to make a change. Okay. But I see things balancing out here for you. I feel like things are starting to kind of like fall into place. And again, we have that yin and the yang energy. So it's like there's a balanced energy here. And I think it's helping you move forward. Some of you have like completed something with the World card here that's like that created balance because it was completed, if that makes any sense. But there's definitely change. I feel like there's good things are going to be coming in here for you with the Wheel of Fortune. And I feel like you're manifesting them because we have the Knight of Swords, we have the Magician, and we have the Queen of Cups. So you're manifesting things. And with the Magician being right underneath the World card, it's like you're manifesting something new for yourself. You're stepping into a place of power. You're in control again with that third chakra energy. But it's also coming from your heart. It's like there's like a balance, I almost feel, between the mind and your heart of like what you're wanting to create for yourself. And with the Knight of Swords, I feel like it could be happening quickly or quicker, or you're wanting it to happen quickly. Okay, again, there could be definitely some sort of communication. Both of these, the Knight of Swords and the Magician, are your energy, Gemini. So there definitely could be something, maybe you're dealing with a person, could be dealing with a water sign, but we're going to kind of clarify and see. And then we have the Eight of Swords, the Page of Pentacles, and the Knight of Pentacles. So there's something that maybe kind of gets you up in your head here with the Eight of Swords. It could be that things are moving slowly, like slower than you want. You might want things to happen faster, especially with the Knight of Swords being here. But it's almost like there needs to be a bit of a plan or a practical implementation of like how you're going to move forward in something. Some of you may have to learn certain things or learn certain skills or new skills with the Page of Pentacles in order to progress you forward. I do feel like this has a lot to do with like what you're trying to achieve for yourself or bring into the world in some aspect. So let's kind of see what this is about here. Let's see what this Wheel of Fortune is in the recent past for you, Gemini. What's this Wheel of Fortune for Gemini? We have the Devil energy. So it could have been some sort of karmic cycle here, we have the Empress. It's like you're growing and evolving beyond that. Some of you are just moving past blocks and challenges, things that have kept you stuck. It's like I see you completing that with the World energy here. And again, it's like there's a better balance rather than restriction with the Devil here. It's like there's balance and harmony that's coming in with this change that you're making. And it's like it's allowing you to grow and expand with the Empress energy. So there is a strong like element of overcoming something here. Why the Knight of Swords? We have the Tower. So yeah, fast change, definitely. We have the Four of Swords. It can be very unexpected for some of you. It's like you might, maybe some of you thought it was going to take a longer amount of time, but I see fast change here. Why the Magician for Gemini? Why is the Magician here for Gemini? Justice. So Libra energy. And the Empress. Yeah, it's like there's big changes and quick changes happening. I feel like it's almost like it's a divine aspect here with the Wheel of Fortune, the Tower, that can indicate that spirit, the universe, is kind of intervening here. It's almost like it's forcing you to change, okay, overcome certain things that are going on. But I feel like you're manifesting, there's strong Libra energy. So through Libra season, I feel like you're manifesting, and maybe even while Mercury's in Libra, okay, you're manifesting big changes for yourself. And I feel like you're manifesting a lot of abundance. You're creating a lot of abundance for yourself. And it's by doing the right things and making the right choices with justice here. Things are coming into balance. Things are coming into harmony. So I feel like kind of this Mercury in Libra has been something that's maybe brought a lot of change for you. But again, I feel like it's in a good way. What's this Queen of Cups? Yeah, Four of Wands. Things are working out for you. Success, victory, celebration. We have the Moon with the Fool. Some of you could be starting something new around the Moon cycle. But a lot of you have made this decision to step into something new, followed your intuition. I just see you really in alignment. And again, it's like you've got strong feminine energy here, but also strong masculine energy. Okay, so it's like there's a balanced approach as to how you're going after something or how you're manifesting something here. So something's working out for you. Some of you, it could be a relationship with the Four of Wands and the Queen of Cups. Eight of Wands, Ten of Wands. It's almost just like things are progressing at a very rapid pace, I feel, or they might feel very rapid. And even the Knight of Wands here at the bottom, like there's some sort of quick change and like a completion again of that, with that Ten of Wands, completing and successfully completing something, feeling satisfied is what I just heard. So there's something that is working out for you, even though it's very quick change or requires you to move very fast. I just saw the Lovers. So again, it could be a choice that you make that all of a sudden something takes off, or you may be forced to make a quick decision. Others of you, though, this could be love that could be coming in here as well. So take it how it resonates. What is this Eight of Swords here? What is this Eight of Swords? We have the Ten of Swords, the King of Swords, and the Nine of Cups. Yeah, I kind of feel like it's like you almost have to put something to rest here. Ten of Swords, Eight of Swords, like let something go that you've maybe been holding on to, or a fear that you have. Because I feel as though when you can kind of get that clarity of the mind or master your mind, you're going to see that there's a lot of good things that are around you. And I feel as though it's like you can manifest your wish fulfillment. Judgment. This is a bit of a decision, though. You're having to be clear about going after your wish fulfillment of the Nine of Cups. Or just, I don't almost feel like balancing out the mind is going to help you emotionally as well. Why the Page of Pentacles? King of Wands. Why the Knight of Pentacles? I knew that was going to come out. The Queen of Wands. Thank you. And temperance at the bottom. There's something here. There's definitely something here with a person. What is this about? If you're, it's a very similar energy between you and an individual. We have the Knight of Pentacles, Queen of Wands, and then we have the Page of Pentacles, King of Wands. So, if I said Knight of Wands, I meant Queen of Wands. There is the Knight of Wands here that came out with the Star and the Page of Swords. It's almost like somebody's wanting to, I kind of feel like there's somebody wanting to come towards you or take action. They have some sort of an offer here for you. This is somebody who I feel like you're kind of on the same page as this person. King of Wands, Queen of Wands, and the Page of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles. Like, you're kind of at the same pace. You have the same energy about you with the Wands energy here, but then you're also kind of like moving at a very slow pace. So there's a very, this person, whoever this is, that they're matching your energy. Some of you have let something go, or you're about to let something go. And then you might not see this coming. This is, we have the Star, the Page of Swords, and the Knight of Wands. Now, for some of you, this is like a new person. This could be a new situation. And I say that because there's almost like wish fulfillment. We have the Nine of Cups and we have the Star, which are both wish fulfillment cards or wish granted cards. And it's almost like this person sees an opportunity to come forward. And you're in this space of the King of Swords and the Nine of Cups. So you're in this, you're in this energy of like happiness because you've completed something. Eight of Swords and Ten of Swords. It's like you've let something go. You're definitely very confident in yourself, standing in your power, standing in your energy here. And so you're feeling really good. And it's almost like because you're in this good space, that allows this opportunity to come in with this fire sign, earth sign, maybe an Aquarius. Okay, so there's something coming in here with another person. It's kind of like a slow and steady. I feel like they might kind of come out of nowhere here with the Knight of Wands, or they're going to follow their passion, their drive. There could be a lot of passion between the two of you as well. But it's like this person wants to get to know you. They want to take the time to get to know you. So this doesn't even have to be love related. This could strictly be like business or something. Some of you, there could be two, like maybe a choice that you have to make around this person coming back in, or coming in general. But for some of you, it's almost like they're new. It's like this person around you is seeing an opportunity to come forward here. Yeah, we have the Ace of Cups, we have the Five of Cups and Five of Wands. So it's almost like once you have to let something go, the struggle, the conflict, you know, the sadness, the disappointment, that's when like this new opportunity comes in, right when you've let something go. And it's something like mentally, like getting a clear mind. So maybe you're just not overthinking things anymore and you kind of let things just naturally flow and happen. And that's when this opportunity or this person can come in for you. So interesting energy. I feel like there's success though, but you've already completed a cycle. And so things are already kind of going in a good direction. There's a lot of change happening. But once you kind of get the ability to kind of get that mental clarity, I think that that's when things are going to really kind of come forward. There might be a specific opportunity, and we have the Ace of Cups, so there's a specific opportunity that could be coming forward here for you. Let's see what your advice is. We have the Emperor here. We have the King of Cups, and we have the Four of Pentacles. And the Chariot. So you're going to definitely be in control here. Your advice is to take control. And take control of your emotions, take control of your practical world, your material, whatever you need to kind of like take control of in your life. I feel like with the King of Cups, there's a need to kind of like emotionally detach from situations in your life, especially if it's something around money or your career. It's like, don't get so invested emotionally. Just kind of like deal with things the way that you need to deal with them on a practical level so that you can kind of get them done and that you can move forward and kind of shift things forward for yourself. Yeah, it's like now, it's almost like now's the time. You don't need to wait any longer. Okay, so to kind of take the reins here and take action and take control of a situation that you're trying to change in your life, because I see you having the ability to do that. You don't have to keep holding on to things that aren't working. So that is what I have for you, Gemini. Kind of a little, like, it felt a little all over the place, but hopefully it made sense. If not, you can check out your signs. But I hope you guys have a wonderful week, and I'll see you all in the next one.